says. There's some arrivals all coming in. Hello, Higgins and Sisters.
Ladies and gentlemen, John Mayfield.
Welcome everybody. My job is to welcome you tonight, and I do that most sincerely. You would know that we are all very deeply sorry Jeannie's not here. Although out there under the trees and in a theatre, I don't think she's all that far away, probably. But we wish you she was here. In her best years, she lit up our lives in unforgettable ways, and she was a real star. You may not know, some of you, that Jeannie and Judy shared a birth date. Jeannie was a year younger than Judy, but every 18th of April each year, there were greetings exchanged, and we sort of did something. There was a giggled question like, what did you get? And greetings were exchanged, and it kept us together. And it was Jeannie that in 1986 drew some of the threads together, the Jubilee 150 year for South Australia. 350s or 150, that ought to add up to the possibility of a government grant for some form of formal education. And we had a party, and it was at Edmund Wright House for the 350-year-olds, and Jeannie swimming gently behind, and it was a corker party. A real cracker, and many of you would have been there. And Jeannie scripted every second of it, all the way down to the scented soap in the toilet. That was 1986, and the 60th birthday slipped by, and this year, in our 70th, for John and Judith and John, we quietly made the suggestion to John that he might like to join us in a 70th birthday. And we were absolutely delighted when he talked it over with Jeannie and agreed to do so. Not only that, Jeannie agreed to join in. And if you think it through, you can probably work out the reasons. But that was a great moment. And so we're here tonight on a celebration of not 370s, but 370s and a 69. And I know that's been troubling some of you for the last few weeks, but that's how we got 279 or whatever the number was. And I guess we should have been a bit careful with 370s and 69. but then that just happened. And I can tell you that Jeannie, having agreed to be part of this, has scripted every second of this celebration. And we're very glad of it. Check the toilets. The Robin Hood. They'd better be right, Judith. The concept of tonight was straight Jeannie Bishop. We would offer, according to her, as many entertainments and to as many of those people who have made our lives such fortunate lives in the last 70 years, some form of entertainment tonight. It's our gift to you people who have been such supporters of us. We would gather somewhere pleasant. We would gather somewhere pleasant on a Sunday afternoon for a round of bubbles, as she described it. Someone she knew from a deep love of the theatre would then present a short entertainment just for us, and then we would head off to the nearest pub for a nice Sunday night tea. It would be us offering good friends an occasion we hoped they would enjoy in recognition of the joy of their friendship has given us. I happen to be on the Marrottville High School Governing Council. And I happen to know Kate Castine, who had this forge, this performing arts centre built, I think, especially for this occasion. The current principal of the school, who's doing all the things that Kate had set up for him, and the school is just going marvellously, has given us a really good deal. And so that's how we have sort of come to be here instead of the entertainment centre or the festival or one of those other venues. This was Jeannie's plan, and I reckon John and the boys had that in mind when they decided that the show would go on. We hope you enjoy what is to follow, and to introduce the special entertainment that we are about to offer you, would you please welcome one of the great blokes around this town, John Bishop. Yeah.
Thank you all very much indeed. My job is quite simple. I'm going to introduce the star performer for the night, but I can't just let Mayfield get away with some of those things. That arithmetic stuff, it does remind me, and those who are at the J150 may remember that I charged him and a lot of his cronies with being responsible for education in South Australia, and how it was that we had a situation where a third of the population couldn't read, and a third of the population couldn't write, and the other half couldn't add up. I just do add my words of welcome to you all tonight. We're in for a fun night. It's going to be a celebration, and I'm really looking forward to it. And as John has said, it was Jean's idea of how we might go about this. And about 5 years ago, I think it was, she and I went to a one-man performance in at the Adelaide Club of an American-born fellow who did a performance that related to a lot of Australiana, Adam Lindsay Gordon, and just was absolutely superb. And about a year later, we ran into the same gentleman at the Bakehouse Theatre where they had a Festival of One, and he performed a one-man show there, which we thoroughly enjoyed. Then a year later, we ran into a beautiful production down at Holden Street Theatres, The Unexpected Man. This same gentleman with a female partner, a beautiful two-hander that got absolute rave reviews. And so it just seemed a dead set Monty that we would ask him if he would do a little performance for us tonight. A quick phone call to the Uni of SA, where he's a lecturer, a quick consultation with the Mayfields, and it gives me extraordinary pleasure to welcome Rob McPherson to the stage, and you will find him fully committed.
Wanted you to be the gift to share with their friends this evening, Rob. Mm-hmm. I'm so glad you'll be joining us for dinner. I think you're going to be the centre of attention. By the way, nobody needs to ring Sam for a crime reservation at the Robin Hood. We
have
got the matter.
Just don't have the iron trophy.
So could you please show your appreciation again?
Thanks to John and Judy and John for hosting me, and this performance is in honor of them. I've gotten to know them both rather better over the last few months we've been planning this, and the performance tonight really was dedicated to Gene, who I'm a great patron of the theater and something of a fan, and it's, you know, just sorry she couldn't be with us tonight. So this was for Gene. Did you want me to?
I've got a bit of housekeeping.
There you go. Go for it.
I got some housekeeping. You probably know this. Ladies and gentlemen, fantastic. Can I just now invite you to make your way to the Robin Hood Hotel, Kensington, and when you turn right onto Portrush,
yes,
almost immediately around the corner on the left-hand side, you'll see a pink balloon, another one of our pink balloons. And if you pull in where that pink balloon is, there's about 50 car spaces there, so that's just before the Robin Hood. Enjoy, have a great time, and we'll see you there. Front bar, or not front bar, but the bar at the side, we've got drinks ready to go. Fantastic.
Thank you.
will be starting up just momentarily. So please find your seats. Make sure you have a drink. Get ready for some laughs and entertainment. Ladies and gentlemen, it gives me the absolute pleasure to introduce my father and good.